what I'm talking about.
Wait!
Okay, now, from the beginning.
Let's rock and roll, gentlemen. That is simply sensational.
Holy cow!
Wow! Oh!
Very nice.
Absolutely brilliant.
I just think it's fantastic to be here witnessing Hero CPL.
It's a sea of yellow.
Magnificent.
This is absolutely stunning.
Goodness me.
Astounding.
Time to have another party here in Guyana. Hashtag biggest all.
This is your News Source Evening Bulletin for today, Thursday, the 8th day of September in the year 2022. I'm Gordon Mosley reporting, and here's what we're tracking tonight. Guyana joined the rest of the international community today in mourning the death of the longest-serving British monarch, Queen Elizabeth II. The Queen died at one of her homes in the United Kingdom this afternoon, with close relatives at her side. Her eldest son, Charles, has now become King Charles III. In a statement, President Irfan Ali said the Queen's passing marks the end of an era in the history of the British monarchy, the United Kingdom, and the Commonwealth of Nations. As a former British colony, Guyana is a member of the Commonwealth. According to the President, Queen Elizabeth's place in history is assured and her legacy is intact, adding that her long and impactful reign has helped to shape the post-World War II era. He said Her Majesty has been a source of stability for her country, and she will be long remembered for her sterling leadership of the Commonwealth of Nations. The President noted that the Queen's visits to Guyana over the years are recalled with great fondness. He said at this time the thoughts of all Guyana are with the members of the royal family and the people of the United Kingdom. He said Guyana joins in heralding the life of the longest-serving British monarch and mourn her passing. Queen Elizabeth II last visited Guyana in 1996 as part of an official Caribbean tour. She last met with the Guyanese head of state in 2017 when she welcomed former President David Granger to Buckingham Palace during an official visit to the UK as president. Guyana gained independence from Great Britain in 1966 and formally cut all ties from the UK in 1970 when the country attained republic status. More news in a moment.
Man, I've been getting this feeling lately. I don't know where it's coming from. I got this itch to win and win big. And I got to scratch it. Activate, scratch, win big. With GGT's blazing hot summer promotion, which runs from July 1st to September 30th. Activate a data plan or bundle and receive a link to your digital scratch card every Saturday. Tap the link, scratch, and you can be a winner of one of our amazing prizes of electric bikes, TVs, laptops, tablets, food vouchers, and so much more. It's gonna be a blazing hot summer with GGT's Scratch and Win promotion.
Are you looking for the best high school education at affordable fees? Then register your child today at the VYC Academy. Now enrolling grade 7 and 8 students for the 2022-2023 academic year. VYC Academy, achieving academic excellence. For more information, call us on 227-1013 or WhatsApp us on 613-4806.
Office Max, we're all all about customer satisfaction. Whether it's clothing and shoes for the ladies, gents, and kids, or for the latest electronics or hardware appliance, we're always thinking of satisfying you, our dear customers. Now you can shop online at www.giftlandofficemax.com or visit us at the Giftland Mall, where we're happy to serve each and every one of you.
Do you know that the final tax on income from mining of gold has been reduced? Gold declared by an individual and valued by the central authority will be subject to withholding tax of 2% of gross proceeds for every value under US$1,100 and 2.5% of gross proceeds from gold valued above US$1,100. This measure took effect from June 1, 2022, following an amendment to the Income Tax Act. The amendment also makes provision for the said tax to be collected by the central authority, aggregated and remitted to the Commissioner General on or before the 14th of the new month, following the month in which any payment and distribution were made. For more information, contact GRA's Tax Advisory Services Section 227-6060, extension 8000.
Win a full gaming setup, Xbox X, gaming chair, gaming speaker and headset, or any of over 60 weekly prizes like Oculus Quest 2, Mini 2 Drone, Nintendo Switch, and many more top gaming prizes. Check below for details.
Let's tell you now that U.S. career diplomat Nico Theriot has been nominated as the next U.S. ambassador to Guyana. In a statement, the White House said Ms. Theriot currently serves as the principal officer at the U.S. Embassy in Karachi, Pakistan. She previously served as deputy chief of mission at the U.S. Embassy in Haiti. And prior to that, she was director for immigration and visa security at the National Security Council in the executive office of the president. Her other diplomatic stints involved serving in various capacities in Afghanistan, Morocco, Germany, Canada, Barbados, Nigeria, and Iraq. The White House said she is the recipient of numerous State Department Performance Awards, including a Senior Foreign Service Performance Award. She is the holder of a Bachelor of Arts degree from the Louisiana State University and a Master's degree in International Relations from Vanderbilt University. She will replace current U.S. Ambassador Sarah Ann Lynch, who was accredited back in 2019. Ambassador Lynch is preparing to say her goodbyes as the process is set to begin soon for the accreditation of the U.S. Ambassador. The U.S. government recently appointed a new Deputy Chief of Missions in Guyana. The United States government, through the U.S. Agency for International Development, USAID, has announced an additional $22.8 million in new funding for this year to support Caribbean regional development goals related to the climate resilience, youth security, information and communication technology, private sector engagement, and health. The funding also includes $10 million to combat food insecurity in the Caribbean to support priority areas identified by CARICOM under President Biden's Caribbean Zero Hunger Plan. The announcement, the embassy said, coincides with a joint USAID and CARICOM annual review of mutual objectives and priorities concluded on the 1st of September. Back in 2021, USAID announced its 2020 to 2025 Regional Development Cooperation Strategy, which is focused on promoting accountable institutions, economic development, and private sector-led growth. The U.S. Ambassador to Guyana, Sarah Ann Lynch, in a statement said, "The annual review speaks to the importance of CARICOM as a strategic partner on development issues and how highly the U.S. values the Caribbean community." The ambassador also noted several of the same issues, namely energy, food security, and finance, that were raised at the Summit of the Americas, and global climate change concerns also were discussed at a partnership to address the climate crisis 2030. The CARICOM Deputy Secretary General, Dr. Armstrong Alexis, remarked that CARICOM is pleased to have USAID as a partner. He said USAID support for CARICOM 25 by 2025 agenda is an important step to achieving food security in the region and building a stronger and more vibrant Caribbean for all.
whatever you need, you got it. Come to and get your mortgage. Live the dream with Republic.
95 to 100% financing. 50% waive off negotiation fees. Plus one lucky person gets their mortgage paid in full. Turn someday into today. Talk to Republic Bank about your low-cost mortgage today.
Team Rodney and 592 Lounge presents Ailita with Mr. Killer live in concert, doing all his big hit songs. With music by Deliranks, DJ Hell, DJ Roti, DJ Zaya, and DJ Aquilo. Saturday, September 24th at McKenzie's Port Club Ground. 314 Greenheart Street, Linden, Guyana. It's Ailita with Mr. Killer live.
Hey yo, GT Massive, this is Double M. All I hear me out right now is all about the Marshall Super Concert, October 1st, right here. It's cricket, it's carnival, it's soca in Guyana. Hey! Ah!
Guyana's Minister of Foreign Affairs, Hugh Todd, is expected to meet with his Surinamese counterpart, Albert Ramdin, within the next 2 weeks to follow up on a recent agreement signed between the two countries and also discuss the issue of fishing license for Guyanese fisherfolk. President Irfan Ali told reporters on Wednesday that the matter with the delay in the issuance of fishing license to Guyanese fisherfolk by the Surinamese authorities is being addressed.
That matter is being resolved as I speak to you. We have agreed that a high-level meeting will take place within the next 2 weeks to not only look at the current issues, because the current issues, we have the full commitment that the current issues will be resolved, but look at the issues in terms of the license itself and how we address that moving forward and in the long term. There are some concerns from their side. We have made our case very clear. We've given all the data. So I'm pleased at the efforts that were made in the last 24 hours to address the immediate concerns in terms of the vessels that were kept there.
The president added that he is pleased that the immediate issue of Guyanese fishing boats not being able to leave Suriname will be addressed. And he said he's looking forward to the meeting between the high-level officials of the two neighboring states. Earlier this week, the Guyana government issued a statement condemning the continued harassment being meted out to Guyanese fisherfolk by the Surinamese government. In a statement, the government also called out the government of Suriname over its failure to grant license to Guyanese fishermen in keeping with the commitment made by Suriname almost 2 years ago. The Guyana government had requested that 150 Surinamese licenses be issued to Guyanese fishermen to allow them to ply their trade in Surinamese ocean waters. The government said that to date it has not been advised on the status of the issuance of the license. It noted that in the absence of the issuance of the license, Guyanese fisherfolk continue to face harassment at the hands of the Surinamese authorities, including fishing vessels that are stranded in Suriname and cannot return to Guyana for fear of losing their license. Over 200 households were affected by floodwaters early this morning in a section of the Providence community after the door for the sluice in the area collapsed, resulting in water from the Demerara River rushing into the community. The breach took place at around 2 o'clock this morning, and within minutes a number of streets, yards and homes were flooded. The Agriculture Minister Zulfikar Mustafa and officials and engineers from the National Drainage and Irrigation Authority visited the area to conduct an assessment early this morning. The Minister of Agriculture explained that a door collapsed as a result of the tide and that engineers from the NDIA were on site working to address the situation and bring relief to those affected. The Minister further explained that a local regional democratic council is responsible for maintaining the structure. He said it appeared as though that was not being done regularly. A temporary stop lock system has since been put in place.
At Giftland Office Max, We're all about customer satisfaction, whether it's clothing and shoes for the ladies, gents, and kids, or for the latest electronics or hardware appliance. We're always thinking of satisfying you, our dear customers. Now you can shop online at www.giftlandofficemax.com or visit us at the Giftland Mall, where we're happy to serve each and every one of you. Are you looking for the best high school education at affordable fees? Then register your child today at the VYC Academy. Now enroll in grade 7 and 8 students for the 2022-2023 academic year. VYC Academy, achieving academic excellence. For more information, call us on 227-1013 or WhatsApp us on 613-4806.
Be on the road for the Cricket Carnival 2022 with the big ass costume bands, Melange powered by Orlando Carnival Downtown, Palm Court Amazonia Brazilian Band, Kayap by the Ministry of Amerindian Affairs, Hit West Side Wild West Band, Hits and Gems Genesis and Utopia Band, and the Pulse Warriors. More bands, more bacchanal, more fun. Log on now to www.cricketcarnival592.com to choose your costume band, and let's party through the streets of Georgetown on October 2nd.
Doors and windows, rooms and more, a brand new rug on the floor. Come to Republic, come to Republic. Whatever you need, you got it. Come to and get your mortgage. Live the dream with Republic.
95 to 100% financing, 50% waive off negotiation fees, plus one lucky person gets their mortgage paid in full. Turn someday into today. Talk to Republic Bank about your low-cost mortgage today.
Get in the game with Buster. Win a full gaming setup, Xbox X, gaming chair, gaming speaker and headset, or any of over 60 weekly prizes like Oculus Quest 2, Mini 2 Drone, Nintendo Switch, and many more top gaming prizes. Check below for details.
Fuel it up and drive, Super 95. Tune up, fuel it up and drive, Super 95. Tune up. Protect your fuel system.
Guyoil Super 95 gasoline gives you more reasons to drive and is available at 56 service stations nationwide. For affordable price, high performance, and high mileage, choose Guyoil's Super 95 gasoline.
Fuel it up and drive!
Across the region tonight, in Trinidad and Tobago, the police there have launched a new program to prevent young persons from joining gangs and engaging in violent crimes. The program is named Gang Reduction and Community Empowerment Project and was launched yesterday at the Police Academy. In delivering the feature address, the Acting Police Commissioner of Trinidad, McDonald Jacob, said the program would be useful in the arsenal of the police service. He said the project had an additional benefit as the data collected from the program would be utilized to create foundations for regional case studies, something he explained that had been sorely lacking in academia. He also said the project would adopt an evidence-based approach and combine prevention, intervention, as well as suppression strategies that encompass strengthening intelligence and investigations, and also seek to work in partnership with communities to address the root causes of violent and criminal gang activities. The Pan American Health Organization has lined up a supply of monkeypox vaccine for Latin America and the Caribbean as the Americas becomes a new epicenter for the rapidly spreading disease. In a statement, PAHO said it has secured an agreement with the company to provide 100,000 doses of monkeypox vaccines to Latin America and the region through a revolving fund. One official of PAHO said PAHO had received requests from 12 countries and would begin partial deliveries later this month. Health officials have warned that a reliance on vaccines in short supply and questions over their best use are hampering efforts to curb the global spread of monkeypox in countries where it had not been endemic. There are just 1.5 million vials of the vaccine either administered or currently available in the 10 worst affected countries, which account for nearly 90% of all monkeypox cases. The vast majority of those doses are in the United States. And finally tonight, international news. Queen Elizabeth II, the UK's longest-serving monarch, died at Balmoral at age 96, after reigning for 70 years. She died peacefully on Thursday afternoon at her Scottish estate, where she had spent much of the summer. The Queen came to the throne in 1952 and witnessed enormous social change. The BBC says her son, King Charles III, said the death of his beloved mother was a moment of great sadness for him and his family, and that her loss would be deeply felt around the world. He said they all mourned profoundly the passing of a cherished sovereign and much-loved mother. During the coming period, he said he and his family would be comforted and sustained by their knowledge of the respect and deep affection in which the Queen was so widely held. The King and his wife Camilla, now Queen Consort, will return to London on Friday, the Buckingham Palace said. Senior royals had gathered at Balmoral after the Queen's doctors became concerned about her health earlier in the day. All the Queen's children traveled to Balmoral near Aberdeen after the doctors placed the Queen under medical supervision. Her grandson and now heir to the throne, Prince William, and his brother, Prince Harry, also gathered there. The Prime Minister of the UK, Liz Truss, who was appointed by the Queen on Tuesday, said the monarch was the rock on which modern Britain was built. And that's your News Source Evening Bulletin for tonight. I'm Gordon Mosley, reporting and encouraging you to stay safe.